Hi everybody, we're going to go ahead and start talking about a new concept which are called conditionals. Now conditionals are really, really interesting because you've probably seen something similar to conditionals in other parts of life. A conditional is basically an if-then situation. If something happens, then something else also is going to happen. Maybe for example, if you make your sprite move, then the sprite is also going to go ahead and make a sound. This is really cool because you can have the program operate independently of you having to cause different things to happen with these conditional statements. Now let's go ahead and get started. Here I have a scene where I've got a dinosaur attacking a city. So what I'm thinking is that I need to make a couple things happen when that dinosaur gradually starts to hit different buildings. So first of all, we're just going to start off with the basics. Let's try when this sprite clicked. That's going to be our event block. Now, the main place where you're going to go for conditionals is over here, the control section, because here is where you'll find those blocks that have if and then on them. Here's one. Here's another one. And then all of these different blocks are technically considered conditionals. But for the sake of this, we're going to go ahead and start off with if, then. Now you'll notice that there's a tiny little hexagon right here. That hexagon is a space where you can put another block to start off your if-then statement. What we call this is nesting. When you take a block and you put it in this little spot here, that is called nesting the block. So let's go ahead and find a block to put in there. Let's say, for example, that when the dinosaur hits the edge of our screen, he's going to do something. So first of all, we'll go up to sensing. And we'll go to this block right here, touching. Take that and watch what happens. It's kind of hard to see, but see how right behind that the hexagon actually highlights? So when you let go, there you go. The block has become nested in the if area. Now to go ahead and select, let's say edge. So when our actual dinosaur is touching the edge, he's going to then do something. So what do you think he should do? Let's go with something in the sound category. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and have him make a sound. Let's say, for example, that he's just going to go ahead and make some sort of a drumming sound. We'll drag this block over and plop it right underneath the then. So theoretically, when we click the dinosaur, if he's touching the edge of the screen, then the drum is going to play for approximately 2.2 beats. Now, let's go ahead and make that a little bit longer. We'll do 3 beats. Okay? All right, let's go ahead and give it a try. Now, the important thing to remember is that it has to be touching the edge of the screen. So, for you to see it, I'm going to go ahead and drag him right over here to where he's touching the edge of the screen. Are you ready? And click him. Perfect. It played drum one for 3 beats. Let's go ahead and try something else. Let's take this one away. And let's say that if he's touching the edge, then he's going to move back. So we'll go move, and we'll replace this with negative 15 steps. Okay, so let's go ahead and try, and we'll click him. Perfect. Because he was touching the edge, the then statement caused him to move back negative 15 steps. Fabulous. All right, now let's try something a lot more interesting with this. So we're going to go ahead and get rid of this. And we're going to go ahead and add actually what we just learned about conditionals to some other actions that we can do with blocks at the exact same time. So you can see that you can use conditionals to your advantage. So I think what I want to do is I want to make my dinosaur move across the screen, and then when he hits the edge of the screen, there should be a sound that comes up. So there's a couple things I'm going to need to do. First of all, let's go ahead and set up our scripts area to represent the moving across the screen. So I'm going to go up to events and pull when green flag is clicked up. Pretty typical by now. I know you know what you're talking about when we talk about when green flag is clicked. Now, I'm also going to go ahead and use a little bit of looping. We're going to do repeat 10 times. And let's have him gradually move every couple of steps as he goes to the edge. So we'll do move 10 steps, and for this sake, we're going to do 15. And then so we can see a pause between each of them. Let's also go ahead and have wait 1 second. So he'll move 15, wait 1 second, move 15, wait 1 second, and so on and so forth. Now at the end of that, if he is touching the edge, I want him to go ahead and make a sound. So we're going to go ahead and grab the if-then block, drag that over. Now, can you remind me, where do you think we're going to find the block that's going to go in here? That's right, sensing. Drag this over. Remember, you have to look for it to be highlighted. And then select edge. Now, to get a sound, we go over to sound. And right now, I actually have this predetermined to be scream male 1. I went over to my sounds category, and I found this in my list that I have. It's the closest thing we have to a dinosaur roar. But remember, if you want to find your own, you can either click here, upload one from your computer, or you can actually go ahead and record your own. Totally up to you. Okay, let's go back to the scripts area. So we'll drag play sound, scream male 1 over here and drop it in. Okay, I think we're ready. So theoretically, when I click the green flag, my dinosaur is going to move 15 steps and wait 1 second 10 times. And then if he's touching the edge, there will be a sound that plays. Let's go ahead and check it out. Here we go. Now he's slowly moving to the edge, but really what it comes down to is if he's actually going to go ahead and touch the edge in order to make the sound. So not quite. So let's go ahead and we'll move him a little bit closer. Let's put him about right here. Second try begins now. He's getting close. Excellent. That is exactly what we wanted to happen. All we did is just went ahead, put our blocks together, made sure that we had a conditional, and it went ahead and triggered a particular action happening when the if statement was made to be true. And there you go, your first introduction to conditionals.